شخص تراول از شرق به غرب و از غرب به شرق سفر کنید. چنانچه علاقمند هستید از ایران و یا از هر کجای دنیا به آمریکا سفر کنید، شخص تراول برای اخذ ویزای توریستی و دعوت شما برای دیدار از دیدنی‌های لاس وگاس، نیویورک، واشنگتن و هاوایی و بسیاری از ایالات مختلف آمریکا در خدمت شماست. 310-477-9400. و اگر در آمریکا هستید و قصد دیدار از زیبایی‌های ایران را دارید، شهرزاد تراول با تورهای بسیار جالب شما را به دیدار از مکان‌های دیدنی شیراز، اصفهان، همدان، کرمانشاه و بسیاری از نقاط دیدنی ایران دعوت می‌کند. با شهرزاد تراول از شرق به غرب و از غرب به شرق در دنیا به روی شما باز است. 310-477-9400. قابل توجه فروشندگان منازل در اورنج کانتی، ما در کلر ویلیامز لاگونا نیگل آماده ایم خانه شما را حداکثر با 1% کمیسیون لیستینگ و 2% کمیسیون فروش، جمعاً 3% به فروش برسانیم. خریداران و سرمایه گذاران ما آماده اند در سریع ترین زمان خرید خانه شما را به قیمت روز انجام دهند. کادر مجرب و آزمودی ما آماده ارائه اطلاعات می باشد. کلر ویلیامز ریلتی، 1-800-992-8315.
به شما بینندگان عزیز، من دکتر نلی فرمیدی ظهیری هستم. به برنامه دیگر از مام تاک خوش آمدید. صحبت گرم و صمیمی برنامه امروزه و خودمونی ما در رابطه با مادران و اینکه ما چگونه میتوانیم با اتحاد بیشتر، با همکاری بیشتر، با به قول معروف صلح‌جویی و صلح‌خویی بیشتر در محیطمون، در جامعهمون، برای خودمون، برای زنان، برای خانواده، برای کودکان آرامش صلح و بیشتر مهیا بسازیم. خب امروز خیلی خوشحالم که پنل و راوند تیبل داشته باشم در مام تاک با مادرانی که پیشرو هستند و این کار رو به خوبی در جامعه ما انجام میدن. اینجا در لس آنجلس مام تاک پرزنتس The Warrior Moms. Welcome, Liz and Lisa.
Thank you.
Such an honor, such a pleasure to have you two. Tell us about what is the Warrior Moms?
So the Warrior Moms is a movement. It's a platform, a website, and then it's also live events. What we wanted to create is we wanted women to have a place to transform and grow in a safe environment. And so we created Warrior Moms so people could, moms especially, could do that. And one thing that Lisa and I had noticed is that women are like volcanoes. They have all this magma right underneath the surface, and they're doing so many things. You know, they're ready to erupt because they just have, they're up to here. They're trying to be the best mother, the best wife, the best employee, the best volunteer at school, the best everything. And we just noticed women are exhausted and depressed and sad, and we really want to empower women to find their inner warrior and to take care of themselves and to really take charge of their life. And one of the things that Lisa and I also talk about is how the women are divided. Moms are divided. We kind of judge each other. I don't think we mean to judge each other, but we can't help ourselves. Oh, she came late to the play date. Oh, she's working a lot. She's not taking care of her kids. Oh, she's not breastfeeding long enough. She's not, you know, there's just so much talk among moms. And we really want to support moms. We want to support each other, and because we are together, we are better. Right. And we really want to support each other and not come from that judgmental space.
Right. And we have a clip to show, sort of.
Yes. Yes. Oh, let me tell you what it is. It's there was this great commercial. I think you've seen it before. Okay. It's a Similac commercial, and it's called In the Motherhood. Mm-hmm. And it's all about. It's kind of funny, but you'll see. It's very, very poignant in the end. About all these groups of moms who are kind of fighting and trying to vie for a position. Mm-hmm.
So let's watch this video clip together. It's about moms not supporting each other, yes, or being divided, as you say. And we'll be back to talk more about how we can cultivate unity together. Stay with us.
Police have arrived.
100% breastfed, straight from the source.
Drug-free pole birth,
dolphin assisted.
Oh.
Well, you push, we cuddle.
Yeah, cuddling is bonding.
Helicopter mom, 12 o'clock.
Must be mommy's day off.
Oh, that's sexist. What? Want to go somewhere? No.
Oh, disposable diaper. Well, apparently we don't care about the environment.
Oh, look, it's crunchy granola mom.
It's getting real.
I wonder what it's like being a part-time mom.
Ooh. Stay-at-home moms.
I wonder what they do all day.
Mani-pedis.
Looks like some moms are too lazy to breastfeed.
Someone came with their nipples blazing.
Oh, yeah? Well, I popped during conference calls.
Hello. Yeah.
It's not all about the breasts.
Yeah, it is.
No, it's not.
No.
It's about the breasts.
You want a piece of this?
Oh, you want a piece of this? Well, I'll show you some screen-free parenting.
Great.
Nibble up, ladies.
It's go time, I think.
Yeah.
Go.
I'll be back.
Let's do this!
Oh, guys.
همونطور که مشاهده میکنین در رابطه با اینکه ما به عنوان دوست همدیگه، خواهر همدیگه، اینی که با هم اتحاد داشته باشیم، همکاری داشته باشیم و بتونیم واقعا روی اون چیزی که مهم هستش، به قول معروف the bottom line، آرامش، امنیت، حفظ کودکان، فرزندان آیندمون، محیط بهتر مهیا کردن برای فرزندان آیندمون، رو اون چیزایی که مهم هستش توجهمون رو بذاریم و اتحاد و یونیتی داشته باشیم. So Liz, tell us about this video clip and what does it do for you when you watch it?
Well, it chokes us up every time, yeah. I have to say, but it really does show you that at the bottom line, we're parents first. That's what we care about. I could cry about it right now. Mm-hmm. But anyway, the bottom line is we're parents first and we care about our children, and that is what unites us. We're all doing the best that we possibly can.
Yes.
Yeah. And many times we lose sight because we're so busy, we're so fast, you know, moving towards this modern lifestyle and these goals that have created this space, and there's a disconnect now almost between our values and what we really used to be focused on, right? The safety, the security, the well-being of our families, of our nation.
Exactly.
What's important to
us. For us, when we were developing the idea of the Warrior Moms, it was that it's a movement. It's an entire movement to move away from being divided and judging each other, like in that show, mm-hmm. or in the clip there, and really bring us all together and make a platform for women to go and come together.
And
was really the idea behind it.
I like how you have focused on what's key, crucial to the togetherness,
right.
Which is, you know, let's instead of judging each other, mm-hmm. instead of trying to
compete, yeah,
have one leg up,
right.
with the other person, really come together.
Well, mm-hmm. sharing our stories, I mean, that is the way we grow and learn. If we don't, I could go through something and I would just be by myself, but if I share it with you and then you say, oh my gosh, I went through the same thing, and you tell me, oh my gosh, I feel for you, I went through this too, here's how I got through it, my life is completely enriched and changed by that.
And I've been so inspired by your life story, but please tell us about your life story so our audience will be inspired as
yes,
well.
Yes, I think that it really started with when I went through infertility. Mm-hmm. So I had to go through in vitro, and I thought that was the worst thing I was going to have to go through. So once I did in vitro and I did in fact get pregnant, I thought my troubles were over. And then I had a really, really hard birth with my son, Landon. He had the cord wrapped around his neck 5 times. He had a stroke. We didn't know whether he would live or die. We didn't know whether he would be brain damaged. And instead of reaching out to friends, I felt ashamed. I hid away, and I felt embarrassed that I wasn't going to get to go home from the hospital with my child. He was in the hospital for 52 days. And so I kept having friends reach out. They wanted to know, like, what was going on. And I finally told them what was going on. And when I accepted that help, when I shared my story, it gave meaning to my suffering. I felt so much better. And I got support from some really great moms. They brought me meals. They were very sweet to me. And around this time, I was feeling like a warrior. I was feeling like I was in the trenches, showing up to the NICU every day, hoping that my son, his condition would improve, and smiling at him. And I dressed up. I put on jewelry. I showed up. I was going to war. Mm-hmm. So I felt like a warrior mom. And I started a blog at that time called One Fabulous Mom. Mm-hmm. And the blog was called One Fabulous Mom because I was hoping one day I would be fabulous again. I wasn't feeling very fabulous, but I wanted to feel fabulous. One day I thought I might. Mm-hmm. And so I started this blog, and I found this whole mom community, mm-hmm. this amazing mom blog community, and I was so supported. And that I've had that for 9 years now. But still, something was bothering me. I have all these great friends. I've got some support now. And I just felt like there was something missing. I feel like women really need a live event, a website, a movement, mm-hmm. so we can come together in this way.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And how wonderful, how beautiful that you are integrating your personal life experience mm-hmm. along with your friends and your community and your life story, and through this narrative approach, you're reaching out to the world.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
You're reaching out to the world. You're reaching out to women in the Middle East. You're reaching out to women in Europe and Canada.
You know, Nelly, when we first started this idea, we were thinking, who is our audience here?
Yeah.
And who can benefit from this sort of community and this movement, this mm-hmm. platform we were building? Mm-hmm. And it really came down, and it was so simple, that every mom is a warrior.
Mm-hmm.
Nelly, you are an amazing warrior mom. I've seen you at school.
Thank
I've
you.
Seen you raise your children. And, you know, every day as a mom, we just fight for our children.
Mm-hmm.
And by definition, we are all warrior moms.
Mm-hmm.
For me, wanting to move and get closer with a lot of my fellow mother friends, mm-hmm. I saw them suffering across a variety of issues, whether, you know, a mom is dealing with a life-threatening disease like cancer, mm-hmm. or they're raising kids that have special needs, or they're going through financial difficulties. There were so many areas that I saw moms struggling and alone and disconnected.
Mm-hmm.
And when Liz and I first started talking about this, we were like, how can we get these women all to be there and support each other? And then not only support each other just as moms, but like to dig a little deeper into these different specific areas that we've sort of called tribes. So certain moms will be in the tribe of having cancer, or dealing with cancer issues, or going through a divorce, and that would be a unique tribe. And you can be a member of multiple tribes. Mm-hmm. For me, I watched all these women going through all these situations and really wanted to build a community for them. And then my own struggles as a mom, you know, I didn't have a lot of guidance. My parents were very absent. So for me, everything I'm questioning, am I doing this right? Am I being a mindful parent? And I think you're one of the most mindful parents I know. And a lot of the topics that you cover on your show are about mindful parenting. When your child says you love your phone more than you love me, you know.
Yes. What kind of your daughter said that to you. Yes.
She said that. And, you know, I struggle with that as a parent. Mm-hmm. I mean, I think it's a really strong topic in our current world.
I think a lot of moms feel like they're flying without a net.
Yeah.
And we don't admit it. Mm-hmm. We refuse to admit that we're having a hard time. I don't know why that is taboo. Mm-hmm. I don't think sharing your brokenness and sharing the things you're going through makes you weak. I think it makes you strong. Mm-hmm. And I think it really helps other people. And I think even though it's very scary to share what you're going through and it doesn't feel natural, you want to run from a problem. You don't want to run towards the problem. Mm-hmm. But I think when you do that, when you shine the light in the dark place, it changes lives.
And I love that you're focusing on compassion. Compassion seems to be at the heart of the matter.
Oh, yeah.
And you are opening up your hearts and souls and reaching out to moms and giving them a space, a place where they can be broken. Mm-hmm. They can feel like they can trust to open up and talk about their vulnerabilities.
Absolutely.
And we know as women, we grow through connection. You know, it's always...
And I think we forget that in today's society.
Yeah.
We get very distracted. So
right.
And we want to give them a platform to do that, because I don't know that there are a lot of areas that you can go out and connect with other moms right now.
Yeah. Well, tell us, for the viewers who are interested to learn more about the Warrior Moms, getting connected, joining a tribe, tell us about your website. And
so
how can we join?
In order to reach as many women as possible, we developed a website, and it's www.thewarriormoms.co, just C-O. And on the website, you can find information just about the company that is behind it, and also more about the movement. You can learn about our live events, and you'll also be able to register for future information and join your specific tribe, and that will allow you to connect with people. You know, we're all connecting just as a mom, as I mentioned, but to be able to drill down into deeper, more meaningful conversations, topics that are of interest to uniquely interested to you. So they'll be just exactly as I mentioned, not only the tribes of women going through adversity and hopefully sharing hope with their stories, but also women that are trying to start their own business, looking to grow their business, looking for resources. We can support each other through a myriad of ways, whether it's through sickness, but also in health and growth and prosperity. So that will be available on our website. And we'll also be featuring our live events, which I think Liz can cover
a little bit. Yeah, one thing we were saying before, the connection, but I think the most important thing is to be together in person, if you can. Sometimes it's not possible, that's why we have the website, but if you can come to a live event, I think that is so powerful. Having 300 women meditating together, learning how to meditate, 300 women doing Tai Chi, doing yoga, is very powerful. Mm-hmm. You can feel that. Mm-hmm. And so we're going to have these live events. There'll be everything from a day-long event, to a weekend, to a week. And you'll be able to come and you will be able to hear great speakers and to learn how to meditate, how to do yoga, how to be a mindful parent. But again, like Lisa was saying, maybe you're starting a business. We're going to have little breakouts about branding and how to start a business or financial freedom. Or maybe you need a little marriage reboot. Maybe you feel like, you know, your marriage is okay, but maybe you feel a little bored and you want a little marriage reboot. You want to know how to really get connected to your husband. So all those different types of topics, and we'll have breakouts where you could break into smaller groups and we'll be able to talk and connect and share our personal stories, which I think is part of the learning process and so amazing. So we'll have these breakout sessions, and I think having that type of live event for women, we're also trying to have women put themselves on the list. we know you've got a list of to-do lists. We know everybody's to-do list is very long, but we want you to put yourself on the list. Mm-hmm. And at the top of the list, we want you to put, you know, be a warrior mom, come to an event, go sign up for a tribe. We want women to feel like, give yourself something. Mm-hmm. You know, you give to the kids, you give to everybody, give yourself this.
Mm-hmm. And then after, we want the event and the website really to go hand in hand, because so many times you go to these events and you meet these wonderful women and you engage and you have these meaningful conversations, but then you go home and you never talk to them again. Mm-hmm. And you don't have that follow-up and sort of that, you know, you want to be responsible for another person's growth. And so that will live on the website. That's part of the community that we hope that it
provides.
There'll
be a password protected area that you can go in, mm-hmm. and I can check in with you. Like, let's say I met you at an event and you said you were starting a business. Nelly, how did that go? Did you do the presentation? I want to know how it went, so that we can follow up with each other. So it's not just one event and, you know, and done.
So it's an online community where mm-hmm. women are empowering and helping each mm-hmm. other
and
grow mm-hmm. and share, but also the live events mm-hmm. in which you can come and have that face-to-face, belly-to-belly experience,
right.
which
yes.
is awesome. Yeah.
Right. And, you know, this whole thing started when Liz and I it's all getting kicked off with a book.
Okay.
And we're in the process of putting it together now.
Oh,
and it's
exciting.
Really exciting.
Yes, very exciting.
It's called Warrior Mom Stories from the Trenches. And it's a compilation of about 30 unique stories told from the voice of the mom going through it. Mm-hmm. And we're collecting those stories right now from celebrities, mom bloggers, certain high-profile people, and also just regular moms with incredibly inspiring stories that have gone through adversity and give you hope. Mm-hmm. So we're putting that together, and we want to launch that in the next couple months. And then as a follow-up to that, we'll take some of these other stories that didn't, you know, we only have space for 30, but mm-hmm. there's thousands of great
amazing
mother
stories
yeah. out there. And we'll be profiling those also on the website. So it'll be the Warrior Mom of the Month. And their story, and you know, if their story touches you, you could sign up for their particular tribe and go deeper into what's going on with you.
So if some of the moms who are watching us right mm-hmm. now have a life story, a story mm-hmm. of their own that they would like to share with you,
yes.
do they email you? Do they?
You can do it all on our website.
Okay.
So they go to the website, www.thewarriormoms.co.
Yes, not .com.
Yes.
.co.
And mm-hmm. there it is.
There it is.
And you'll
Beautiful.
Be able to join us for our mailing list, where we'll send out information about our future events that we are in the moment trying to put together for early 2016. Mm-hmm. And then you can sign on and put your story to be the profiled warrior mom. And we just really would love as many people to get involved as possible. We're all here and are going to grow together.
Absolutely. Awesome. And I think what's great about having it on the website too is we're going to profile them, we ask them these questions, but then also if you want to promote your business, if you're a mompreneur and you've got your own business, you can put your business on there. We are happy to help women in any way mm-hmm. That we can. And one thing I've noticed is that when a mom is featured, mm-hmm. you know, or when we tell a mom, I've had moms say to me, I don't know if my story's good enough. I don't know if it's good enough for the book. Mm-hmm. And that just breaks my heart. Because women have amazing, amazing stories to share, and they don't even think their stories are good enough. Mm-hmm. And we actually brought a clip to show you, just to show you how much it means to a mom mm-hmm. or a woman when they are complimented. It's almost like they don't even hear it. They're so used to looking in the mirror and just feeling terrible about themselves.
Or invisible.
Or invisible, mm-hmm. right. Where they just don't. They don't feel like they're enough, mm-hmm. and there's this great band called the Mrs. Band, mm-hmm. and they're an all-female band, over 40, they're just incredible.
Wow.
And they all just learn to play instruments later in life. I mean, they're amazing women. And they did this viral video called The Mirror, and they put a mirror up in a mall, mm-hmm. and you should see what happens when women walk up to this mirror.
All right, do we have this video clip ready? Let's break to the mirror.
Yes, it's the
video
up for the Mrs. Band mirror.
How do you feel when you look in the mirror?
All right. Why'd you say that? You can talk to me. It's okay. We're friends.
Oh, my God. Sorry, Marie.
Don't be afraid of the reflection you see. You are an amazing woman. And today, I want you to look in this mirror and not just feel okay. You are an inspiration. You care so much about your family. Instead of dropping out of college, you brought your daughter along the whole time. Even though things were difficult, you kept on going with dignity, grace, strength. You have become an inspiration, and I'm not the only one that thinks that.
Hi, sweetheart. Hopefully this is still a surprise. We wanted to tell you how truly inspirational you are to so many people.
You've always put me first, and you've always taken every opportunity to tell me how proud you are of me. And I just want to take this opportunity to tell you how proud I am of you.
I couldn't do any of what I do without your support.
When I fell into a coma last year, I woke up, and my family was there, and you were there.
You were there in the room when I got the call that my dad was dying, and you held me tight and cried with me, and then you took care of my kids.
I'm so lucky to have you as my wife, as my best friend. You're the best mother ever. You're the greatest advocate for our sons, Brent and Harry, and we love you, and you should be very, very proud.
You are beautiful, not just on the outside, but you are so much on the inside. A moment does not go by that people don't see that.
Sweetest thing in the whole world. Whoever put this together is just the most wonderful, thoughtful person.
And now, how do you feel? Slide it, girl. What does that say?
I'm enough.
Let me hear it again. I'm enough.
I'm enough.
Turn around.
Gift in the world to know that she's proud of me.
What just happened was one of the sweetest things I've ever experienced.
I rise above. I know I'm enough.
بله دوستان، به برنامه مادر و کودک ادامه میدیم. در این کلیپی که مشاهده کردین، مادرانی که در آینه خودشون رو میبینن و اون عکس العمل، واکنش یا اون شیوه مهربونی، عشق و علاقه‌ای که دیگران، همسرشون، فرزندانشون، خانوادهشون براشون دارن در آینه بهشون منتقل میشه و در این آینه گونگی هستش که کانکت میکنن و احساس شفقت و کامپشن تجربه میکنن. به دنباله برنامه ادامه میدیم. در این بخش برنامه با گروهی از مادرانی که انجمن یا این به اصطلاح پلتفرم موومنت واریر مامز رو ساختن میپردازیم به این گفتگو و مهمان گرامی عزیز دیگری داریم در این برنامه که ایشون هنرپیشه هستن، مادری هستن که زندگی ایشون و تجربیات ایشون ما رو کمک میکنه آشنایی بیشتری داشته باشیم از اینکه چگونه با کامپشن، با عشق و با محبت به همدیگه، به خصوص در گروه ما مادران، میتونیم با این اتحاد و همکاری همدیگر رو به ارتقای بهتری، بالاتری و آگاهی بیشتری و محبت و صمیمیت و صلح‌جویی بیشتری ببریم. به برنامه ادامه میدیم. Warrior Moms, welcome again to Mom Talk. It's such a pleasure. Tanya, it's a pleasure to have you. Welcome
to
Mom
Talk.
Thank you.
So let's continue our dialogue about the unity. We're better together. Yes. Right, we're better together.
Absolutely.
And what's your story, and how can we connect with you and join you in this movement?
My story came from the fact that I was very blessed to get pregnant after 40, got pregnant naturally, and wanted to have a baby more than anything in the world. And about 4.5 months into it, I was on my kitchen floor on all fours, crying so hard, snot coming out of me, tears, and I'm going, what's going on? I'm pregnant, I'm happy, I want this baby. Mm-hmm. And I actually started going to therapy because I thought, something's wrong here. But I went through and everything seemed fine. I thought, oh, it's just being pregnant. It's part of being pregnant. And then I have my beautiful daughter. I did have a traumatic birth. I had a C-section, which I planned, but then I had a horrific reaction to the epidural. Mm. And I basically went into shock and I couldn't stop shaking and I couldn't stop throwing up for 6 hours.
Oh, goodness.
So all these moms were coming in, having their baby off to their room. Mm. And I'm in recovery and the nurse had heated blankets and heaters on me and I'm just violently shaking. She even said in 35 years she'd never seen anything like it. And then in amongst that they bring in my brand new baby and go, can you try and breastfeed? And I'm like, oh, you know.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
So then I finally got up to my room. The rest of the time went fine. And I go home and I have this baby and I'm all thinking this is wonderful. I was okay for about a week or so. And all of a sudden I started to disconnect. And I couldn't understand it. And I thought, well, I'm tired. It's got to be I'm tired. Mm-hmm. Then I really started to disconnect. And I couldn't wait for someone to come so I could leave. And I'm looking at this beautiful, perfect baby going, why don't I want to be here? Why am I feeling this way? And I would run off to the mall and see all these moms with their newborns, and they're holding them and happy and feeding them. And I'm just sitting there crying going, why don't I want to do that? Then my daughter unfortunately got colic, very colicky. She would cry every night for 5 hours. So my husband and I would take these half-hour shifts doing this. And I never forget, on one Sunday, I'm from England, and I decided that I was going to buy a one-way ticket to Paris, I guess, because I like that city. God bless.
Because why not? I want to go with you to Paris.
And just take enough money for myself and leave my daughter with my husband because they would be better off. Mm. I didn't do it, thank God. But I really felt like that's what I wanted to do. And then my best friend and godmother, Danielle, sat me down. She was crying. She said, something's wrong with you. And I'm like, I'm tired. And I wasn't. It was more than that. People say, just go for a walk. Getting out of the house with my baby was the most terrifying thing. I would just sit there all day long waiting for her to cry, waiting for her to take a nap, and she wouldn't nap as long as I had hoped. It was just all of that. And I fell into a deep depression. And then about 4.5 months into it, and it also affected my marriage, my husband, he, God bless, came to therapy with me. Both my OBGYN therapists wanted to put me on antidepressants. That's not my personal choice.
Mm-hmm.
Total respect for anyone who does go down that path, mm-hmm. because I think there's many roads.
Mm-hmm.
I went to my naturopath, and he put me on 5-HTP and rosehip oil. And at the same time, I read Brooke Shields' book, Down Came the Rain, and for the first time, I was sobbing, because I went, oh my God, this is what I have. I have postpartum depression.
Yeah.
And I didn't realize it, and I started to do research on it and really couldn't find anything on it. Well, thank God, about 2 weeks after I started the 5-HTP and the rosehip oil, I will never forget this. Mm-hmm. I was standing in my kitchen looking out the window, and all of a sudden I went, I think I'm going to be okay. It literally was like,
The fog lifted.
At 5.5 months, I came out of it, and then I went back to work, which I think for me personally, because I'm such a social, I'm a runner, I like to go, I do all these different things. I'm an actress, I'm a jewelry designer, I do all these things. Mm. I think it helped me immensely to get back to who Tanya was and be a good mom.
Yeah.
But that being said, it led me down a different path of why isn't there more information on this? Why?
Or why people are not talking about it.
About, right. Exactly. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And I was fortunate enough to meet an amazing filmmaker named Jamie Lynn Littman. She's a director, and she was a brand new mom. Mm-hmm. So she had this 4-month-old baby. She didn't have postpartum depression, but she interviewed me for a different documentary, and I said, I want you to work with me on this. And she said, oh, I don't know. I didn't have it, thank God. Let me walk away and think about it. Well, she came back to me 2 days later and went, oh my gosh, there's a lot on this subject. So in 2010, we started a path, and one of the women that we interviewed, her name was Lindsay Gerst. We ended up having her come with us, and the three of us produced this documentary called When the Bowel Breaks.
Mm-hmm.
And it covers everything from perinatal mood disorders to postpartum depression to postpartum psychosis, which is an entirely different thing.
Mm-hmm.
We interviewed a lot of testimonials. I am one of them. Lindsay is one of them. A lot of experts, both Eastern, Western medicine.
Right.
And we did so much research. Mm-hmm. I'm always trying to find a common through line. I can't find one.
Mm-hmm.
A couple of the things I can tell you through our experience and research that I found trigger it is, of course, hormones,
mm-hmm.
lack of sleep,
mm-hmm.
lack of nutrition. A big one is lack of community,
mm-hmm.
not
mm-hmm.
feeling like I find the moms that have the sisters, the mothers, the everyone, they come around, they go, we're going to be here, we're mm-hmm. camping out, mm-hmm. here's your food, mm-hmm. go take a shower. Those women tend to do a bit better even if there is trauma.
Right.
I'm an only child. I was on my own. I know. I think that all probably had partly to do with it.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So all of these are things that we cover,
mm-hmm.
And it's a really awesome documentary. We were very blessed. We got Brooke Shields mm-hmm. to not only narrate it, but she also executive produced it.
It's wonderful.
Wonderful.
Congratulations.
Yeah, so thank you so much.
Tanya, it's so inspiring. And I just want to take a moment to translate for our audience who are Farsi speaking, because I'm just so touched and I get goosebumps every time I hear your story. بینندگان گرامی، خانم تانیا از مادرانی هستند که postpartum depression که یک به اصطلاح اختلال روحی روانی هستش که مادران بعد از زایمان تجربه میکنن و تفاوت متفاوت از postpartum blues. به اصطلاح تمام مادران یا خیلی از مادران بعد از زایمان دچار نوسانات هورمونی میشن و ممکنه که کمی افسردگی یا افسردگی خفیف تجربه بکنن، ولی در رابطه با داستان تانیا و تجربه ایشون این به اصطلاح افسردگی شدیدتر بوده، این postpartum depression بوده، ولی خب به خاطر اینکه اون کامیونیتی، اون اجتماع و جامعه‌ای که شاید خانواده یا کسی که دورشون باشه، دوستانی که بتونن کمک بکنن و تشویقشون بکنن که درباره این موضوع بیشتر به اصطلاح باز باشن یا صحبت بکنن، اون سپورت رو نداشتن و به خاطر این و به خاطر اینکه میخواستن قوی باشن، و شاید خیلی از شما مادران براتون این شباهت داره، در بعد از زایمان میخواین قوی باشین، میخواین مادر خوبی باشین، نمیخواین که احساس بکنین که افسرده هستین، ولی در کیس ایشون این آگاهی رو داشتن، این awareness رو داشتن که متوجه شدن که افسرده هستن، افسردگی دارن و نمیخواستن که از قرص ضد افسردگی استفاده بکنن، و بعد با خواندن کتاب بروک شیلدز متوجه شدن که این کاندیشن، این به اصطلاح اختلال رو دارن، و رفتن دنبال ایسترن مدیسن و هربال مدیسن و از استفاده کردن ایسترن مدیسن و به اصطلاح اون سپلمنت ها، چیزایی که اونها رو کمک کرد به مودشون و روحیهشون عوض شد، و در 5 ماه و نیم که بودن متوجه شدن که این افسردگی دیگه باهاشون نیست و حالا بیشتر اشتیاق دارن که با فرزندشون باشن و باندینگ داشته باشن و اون اتچمنت و کانکشن رو با نوزادشون، با فرزندشون در اون موقع تجربه کردن و بیشتر شد این به اصطلاح علاقمندی و دلبستگی و دلبندی. خیلی از شما مادرها شاید در این موقعیت هستین و خیلی توصیه میکنیم، همونطور که تانیا گفتن، این داکیومنتری که دارن داره بیرون میاد، حتما تماشا بکنین. در این داکیومنتری خیلی به شما توصیه میشه که چگونه میتونین کمک بگیرین، یا شاید اصلا بتونین بیشتر آگاهی پیدا بکنین از اینکه تفاوت postpartum blues با postpartum depression و ریسورس ها و اون کمک هایی که برای شما هست چی هستش. When is the documentary going to be available?
The documentary is slated for 2016.
Okay.
We're in the process right now of doing all the legwork to get it out there. And one thing I do want to say to anyone out there who may be suffering through this right now is that there is hope.
Mm-hmm.
Don't keep it to yourself. Talk to people, find your tribe, find your community, go to their website
mm-hmm.
and sign up. I mean, I put myself under that tribe because I am a part of that. The good news is my daughter's now 7. I am madly in love with her. It is wonderful being a mom. It is such a blessing. It was a very difficult time,
mm-hmm.
but I found my way through that, and other women can too.
And that's one of the reasons why we made Tanya our first Warrior Mom of the Month.
Yay!
On our website. And we were really lucky to have her because we really feel like her resilience and her strength is exactly what we're looking for, to inspire other women. And if you are going through postpartum depression, or if you are a warrior mom, and you are because you're a mom, if you're a mom, you're a warrior, sign on to our website.
Yeah.
Awesome. And would this documentary be available online, or how?
I'm sure it will. Definitely, probably end up there as well. I think there's many different avenues that can go down. It will to do with teaching. It's interesting. It's a three-part story in the sense that there are the testimonials and everything I spoke about. The second tier of that would be the three of us all being moms and creating this together. And then the third tier is Lindsay, our other producer, unfortunately still does battle with depression. Mm-hmm. So the through line of the documentary is her looking for ways to work her way out of it. So I think it's a very entertaining documentary. It's not just talking heads. Mm-hmm. And I think it'll be very helpful, very powerful. Yeah. And one of the goals we have with this, that I personally have, is to get legislation passed to do a screening process for every pregnant woman in the world. Mm-hmm. Because there are signs. I think prepartum depression at 4.5 months, and interestingly enough, Ava's doctor, her pediatrician, had said to me, "I didn't know you went through that." Mm-hmm. And I was with you the whole time. I had no idea. And I said, "Do you have a screening process?" She goes, "You know, we kind of do, and none of us do it." So here I am taking my baby in, thinking I'm not even going to survive. And here's someone who could have said, "How are you doing?"
Exactly.
That kind of isolation, as you know, I mean, being a mother, that's the biggest feeling I think all moms have. Oh, whatever you're going through, that feeling of isolation is a killer.
It is.
And it will trap you. It makes you feel stuck.
Shame.
That's one of the reasons why we even started this, is because we want women to know that whatever you are going through, there is another woman who's going through the exact same thing at the exact same time. Mm-hmm. And why not connect and grow and share and learn from each other and support each other and get through it.
Awesome. So we have this last clip to show on
there's a wonderful woman who is trying to get a bill passed, and let's hear what she says about PDD.
Talk about a common medical condition that is too often masked by silence and stigma. It affects more women than diabetes or stroke or breast cancer, and it is postpartum depression. Here are some words from women who have suffered from postpartum depression. From Maria, "I was experiencing anger and rage, and I had suicidal thoughts. I didn't know what's wrong, but I can't take care of this baby, and I'm miserable all the time." From Jody, "My son was sick again, and I was crying so hard I could barely text my mom to have her come over immediately. I waited anxiously at the door with a screaming ill child and greeted her by handing over my son and saying, 'I can't do this anymore.'" And from Heather, "Soon after the birth of my son, I knew something was wrong with me. I couldn't fall asleep, or if I did, I couldn't sleep for long. I also couldn't eat. I forced down every bite of food and spent most of my time crying." These women are not alone. In 2013, there were more than 3.9 million births in the United States. And of these births, one out of every seven mothers were affected by postpartum depression. Women suffering from maternal depression often report overwhelming and isolating feelings of sadness, anxiety, fear, and guilt. This can include strong feelings of anger, thoughts of death or suicide, and even negative feelings towards their baby. Children of mothers with postpartum depression can become withdrawn, have behavioral problems, and higher risk of anxiety disorders, depression, and toxic stress. Yet, even though this condition affects hundreds of thousands a year, many do not seek medical help. Many moms report that they are too embarrassed to admit their feelings or worried they might be seen as failing or being bad moms. It doesn't have to be this way. The good news is that treatment works. 90% of women going through postpartum depression can be treated effectively. And that's why I'm introducing a bill with Representative Costello to make sure new moms are not on their own when it comes to dealing with postpartum depression. The Bringing Postpartum Depression Out of the Shadows Act will offer grants to states to screen and treat new and expecting moms for maternal depression. States and professional groups have made great progress, and we need to support them as they move to increase awareness and consolidate resources. We need to help doctors recognize the signs of postpartum depression and provide access to appropriate treatment. This is common sense legislation to help the over 400,000 women annually who suffer from maternal depression. We need to stand up and tell moms they are not alone. Needing help does not make them bad mothers, and help is out there, but we need to make sure those who need it can get it. I ask my colleagues to co-sponsor our legislation and take this concrete step towards supporting healthy moms and healthy babies. Thank you.
بینندگان به پایان برنامه رسیدیم. Tanya, in closing, such an inspiring clip, and I hope those of you watching in the Middle East and Iran and far away are inspired and you start a movement of your own, because I know in our country, در کشور ما صحبت کردن یا گفتگو در رابطه با افسردگی بعد از زایمان یه چیزی هستش که شرم‌آوره. با خجالت مادرها این صحبت ها رو میکنن و واقعا میبایست که این رو we have to put a stop to it.
Yes,
and
we
be
do.
Active.
As well, and even with her clip and the only way, that has a 3% chance mm-hmm. of passing.
That bill, yeah.
Yeah, mm-hmm. that's it. So, I mean, unless we all as a community, mm-hmm. and I encourage each of you to do so, to get online, and
What I would do is I would call her office, mm-hmm. and I would say, I want to support this bill.
Yeah.
Truly, it will not pass. One of the ways you can get a bill passed is make your voice heard.
Absolutely.
Send out an email to every one of your friends, get the link of where you're supposed to go, and send it to all your friends and say, please call this number or write this email and sign this. Because that, if they don't see numbers behind it, they will not
they
pass
won't
the
pass
bill.
It.
Will you have this information on your website?
You know what, we'll put
yes.
it up there. We'll
Perfect.
Put it up there
yeah.
on Tanya's Warrior Mom of
yeah.
the Month page,
mm-hmm.
Under Be Inspired. I will put that for you, because
awesome.
This is an important bill,
it's
and,
a very
and
important
it,
bill.
Believe
important.
Me, it will not get passed without
Well,
pushing.
And also, too, she said it affects one
We're
in
on
seven
it.
Women.
Mm-hmm.
It's one in five now.
Wow.
It's now one in five.
And
wow.
also, too, I'm just going to say in my documentary,
mm-hmm.
two of the women in my documentary, since we shot the movie, both took their life.
Oh.
So this
that
is
shows
how
you.
Important it is
yeah.
for women to have a community to get help.
Mm.
Absolutely.
So as you can see, Tanya is definitely the true definition of a warrior mom
mm-hmm,
in
mm-hmm.
so many ways, and
mm-hmm.
we're just so honored to have her featured. And you know, her tribe is postpartum, along with other. She's an entrepreneur, starting her own company. But what Warrior Moms is all about is bringing these people together.
Absolutely.
Amazing. Well, ladies, it's been an honor. I feel blessed to be in your company in this circle of unity. And for you guys, for the viewers. خیلی ممنون از اینکه به برنامه ما توجه کردین و حتما به کامیونیتی warriormomsberin.co نه .com و حتما انفورمیشن بگیرین، حتما شاید این ایده رو این ایده رو بگیرین و در محل خودتون، در جامعه خودتون یه همچین کامیونیتی و جامعه رو شروع بکنین. چرا نه، چرا نه که ما زنانی که واقعا فعال هستیم و کارهای خوب میخوایم برای اجتماعمون بکنیم، با همدیگه با اتحاد unity با همکاری پیش بریم. و I always say a happy mom is a happy community, a happy life.
Amen.
You always look to how the community is treating the moms and the children, and you can always know, you know, what's going on in that community. So thank you ladies
thank
for
you,
thank
being
you so
such
thank
force
you are a true warrior mom now
and love and it's an honor.
Thank you.
هفته آینده خدا نگهدار.
بدانید قوانین فدرال در مورد آوردن پول از ایران مرتباً در حال تغییر هستند؟ در دفتر حقوقی یزدانیار تخصص ما مسائل مربوط به تحریم‌های اقتصادی می باشد. قبل از هر گونه مبادلات مالی با ایران با من مهنوش یزدانیار در دفتر حقوقی یزدانیار تماس بگیرید تا ما شما را در این موارد پیچیده قانونی یاری کنیم. شماره تماس 310-780-6360 و یا 415-656-5178.
آیا مشکل کردیت دارید؟ تیم ورزیده آگاه و مجرب کردیت ریپر اسپشالیست در خصوص بازسازی کردیت بد، پاک کردن پرداخت‌های عقب افتاده، ورشکستگی، کالکشن و جاجمنت زیر نظر آریان اقبالی، مدیریت کردیت ریپر اسپشالیست بهترین انتخاب خواهد بود.
سلام، کردیت بد خود را به من و همکارانم بسپارید تا آینده‌ای درخشان را برای شما تضمین کنیم.
Credit Repair Specialist 1-800-685-721-20. به زودی درهای پیکتوریال رگ گالری ارائه کننده متنوع‌ترین و زیباترین تابلوپرش‌ها بسته خواهد شد. در این حراج استثنایی که برای مدتی محدود خواهد بود، شما می توانید تابلوپرش‌های برگرفته از هنر شرق و غرب و هنرمندان صاحب نام را با قیمت عمده فروشی و باور نکردنی خریداری کنید. 818-669-4720 310-698-2994. از شما علاقمندان به زیباترین و نفیس‌ترین تابلوپرش‌ها که به دنبال تابلوپرش‌های چون تابلوهای موزه‌ای با قیمتی نازل می‌گردید دعوت می‌کنیم تا در این حراج استثنایی و برای مدتی محدود به پیکتوریال رگ گالری بیایید. به زودی درهای پیکتوریال رگ گالری پس از حراج استثنایی بسته خواهد شد. 818-669-4720 310-698-2994 پیکتوریال رگ گالری.
درودی دوباره و با چند خبر کوتاه در خدمت شما هستم. نیروهای امنیتی بلژیک 5 مظنون دیگر را در 2 شهر این کشور بازداشت کردند. به گفته دادستانی بلژیک، این عده صبح امروز دوشنبه در بازرسی‌های پلیس از چندین خانه دستگیر شدند. شب گذشته نیز با اجرای چندین عملیات ضد تروریستی در بلژیک، دست کم 16 نفر بازداشت شدند و گفته می‌شود صلاح عبدالسلام، شهروند بلژیکی مظنون به دست داشتن در حملات پاریس، در بین بازداشت شدگان روز گذشته نیست. از سوی دیگر، نخست وزیر بلژیک اعلام کرد بالاترین